need you to realize and accept that there is only one philosophy that I have embraced under the Coach's Corner's umbrella, and that is that we are the common denominator in every situation. So I can't blame them, they, her, and him. I am stepping up to the plate, and I realize it's all me. Not that it's all about me, but it's all about the legacy for those that come behind me to achieve a height of success that I can't even imagine. This is called the transgenerational shift of mindsets, that we may propel ourselves into the generations that is to come and tell them, I won't leave you a mess that you have to clean up, but I'll leave you a principle-centered life that you can celebrate and catapult into more success. Join me on the Coach's Corner at www.415-96radio.com. That's www.415-96radio.com. And follow me on Twitter. That's the only way you can keep up with the coach. That's right. DCC is in the house on SIBN Radio. Tune in.
I'm Nomvula, aka Sunshine, and we here in South Africa are tuned in to SIBN Radio at www.415-96radio.com. If you would like to know more about the SIBN television and radio network, complete a contact form at the website www.415-96radio.com. Salet USA TV, reaching the world.
I want to ask you a question. Who's coaching you? Who's asking you the tough questions? Who's telling you, man, you're the common denominator to all of your issues and challenges? Who's telling you, man, all day long you become the magnetic pulse that attracts to you both good and bad? I want to be your life coach. I want to be the one that cheers you on to the finish line. I want to be the one that you ask the tough questions. And it doesn't mean that I have all the answers, but that means that you have a partner, someone who believes in you, not the you you see right now, but the you can't imagine, the you that you are to become, the you were destined to be. I always say, we both need the positive and the negative. It's not enough to have the knowledge of the matter. But we must have the wisdom as well. For wisdom settles it. And that's what I want to offer you as you join me on the Coach's Corner. I want to offer you the wisdom of the matter. Maybe it might be relationships. Talking about our campaigns for more, for life. The dark room for our subconscious. Our spiritual journey. Whatever it is, I want to be there to encourage you, to build you, to challenge you, to cheer you on to the finish line. I'm qualified to do this. Why? Because I'm you.
Thank you so much for joining us right here on the Coach's Corner. My name is Marcus Sillette, and assuredly, as I approach the microphone on today, I admit that I have my own personal and professional issues, but I like to think that I'm bringing to the microphone the wisdoms of the matter, and I hope that I can make a difference in your life and earn the right to speak, motivationally speaking, into you. And we would be thankful if you would follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, YouTube at Sillette USA TV. That's SALETTE USA TV. And also today we're talking and starting our new series, Faith series, called Faith Life versus the Hustling Life. That's starting on today. Follow us continuously as we intermittently share through our new series for the spring of this year, Faith, how to walk in it, what it means, the various seasons, and so much more. And I also want to say thank you to all of those of you that are following us on the various platforms where SIBN television and radio airs. Thank you so much for those that are joining us at www.wesupportselectusatv.com. And also at 415-96radio.com. This is the Coach's Corner on SIBN Radio. Now let's get right to work. Thank you, Mr. Engineer. We appreciate you so much. I want to encourage you to tell friends as we now plow ahead in this new dynamic of a series called Faith. What it is. We'll have some informal conversations about the faith life. And let's start off with what it means. I was very encouraged when our pastor at our church ministered a message regarding the topic of faith. And I had been feeling the Lord dealing with me on faith in a motivational sense. And so this is not a spiritual program, though it contains spiritual content, be advised. But this is a motivational show. And so we try to bring to the microphone that content for the unchurched or those that may not believe what we believe or how we believe, but yet may share in some of the same principles and values of how we live our lives. And in this instance, particularly in the realm of faith. But let me just lay out for you a storyboard view, if you will, of faith for the believer and perhaps the non-believer. When I say believer, I'm not just talking about Christians, but I'm talking about Christians, Catholics, you know, those who believe in the gospel and those who do not believe. Listen, it is a known fact and a biblical statement that people that do not believe practice more principle-based living, and I'm paraphrasing, than people who do. The scripture says that the children of darkness, if you will, please don't be offended by that, but this simply means those who have not embraced Christ as being the light are more prone to do more work than the people who are going to church every Sunday. So that being said, don't be tickled by your fancy because you go to church every week and think that that is going to be enough work suffice for your faith life. A lot of folks that are going to church and a lot of people that are involved in church are still hustling. And today we're going to talk about the faith life versus the life of a hustler. I need some help. And hopefully you'll be able to gain something out of that. But for those that do believe, there is the overloading of our faith or the faith and foolishness factors that we won't talk about and get to that today. But stay in touch with us with the Faith series. Follow us on Twitter at @SelectUSATV, Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, and the like, YouTube and the like. And, you know, also right here on the station and platform where you may be listening. And you'll be able to see the various topics and subjects. This is going to be a great series prior to our next season of motivational messages. So let's get right to it. Faith is now. No matter what happens, faith is now. It's not a noun, it's a verb. Faith is an action word. It is a word of movement. It is a word of momentum. It is a word that requires participation of the host. I'll say that again. It requires participation of the host. And faith comes by hearing. Now, for the believer, it's hearing by the word, but faith still comes by hearing. That is the central principle that I want you to write down in your notes. That faith comes by hearing. And the more you hear whatever you hear, the more faith in what you have heard comes. I need some help. And so, as we said on the intro, we can't blame them, him, her, for any outcomes that are undesirable in our lives. We have to look within ourselves and be able to determine that I did not have the faith for X, Y, and Z. As long as we're blaming others, we'll never can have and see the victory, right? I am the common denominator in every situation. Not excluding my divinity, but I'm just using that in a motivational sense. Some of you that are church going folks, please don't be offended. But at the end of the day, I can do all things. As Paul was talking to the Greeks and the scholars of his day as they had comparison, contrast conversations and wanted to mix and match and show who had the bigger muscle in culture and in educational concepts. Paul says, well, hey, I can do that. I can. The Greek, the scholars would begin to say, hey, I can go without food and I can fast and I can purify my body. Paul said, I can do that. Other guys say, well, I can be a fat cat and I can eat the best of the best at the best places. And I've got the gold card to the best restaurants, if, as it were, paraphrasing, of course. Paul said, I can do that. In other words, he's not having a conversation with church leaders. He's not having a conversation with a bunch of believers. He's not having a conversation with a bunch of folks who are religious. He's having a conversation with folks who are scholars. And they challenge Paul, look, what do you bring to the table, dude? You can't do this. You can't switch. I got a good friend who's working on a book called The Art of Code Switching. Being able to be relative and applicable in any situation that you find yourself in. Paul finally says, you know what? I can do whatever you do, but I can do all things through Christ. So let's get it straight here. That faith comes by what you hear. So the question could be today, before we talk about the hustling life versus the faith life, what are you hearing? Some of us hear our own thoughts. That may not be a good thing because our own thought patterns can be detrimental to our future. I need some help. Some of us are hearing what our parents or our family members are saying. What are you hearing regarding your future from your family? In other words, who has the bugle or the microphone in your immediate surroundings? Some of you have a girlfriend or a significant other that you keep hearing from. Could it be said, I'm not saying that it is or it isn't, could it be said that love grows because you keep hearing things? Well, psychologists and biologists, to some degree, bear some of that out because men are attracted by what they see, but women are attracted by what they hear. All are grown in development are to the detriment or to the healthy aspect of their development by what they hear. What are you hearing today? And if you never analyze or take assessment of the gathering data of what you have heard or what you are hearing, you will never be able to realign your faith so that it is on track to accomplish the varying tasks that you hope to desire to hope and desire to accomplish. It is essential that you understand that. Now, let's talk about faith life versus hustling life. The hustling life is what it is. It is, I got to get some money so I can pay this bill. And I got X, Y, and Z skills, or I got X, Y, and Z products, or I got X, Y, and Z homegirls, homeboys that I can hit up for a loan, or I got X, Y, and Z ways, whether it be legal or not. I make me 5 cakes and bake 3 cookies. Go on and get me some vegetables on my EBT card. I mean, fruit on my EBT card. I'm calling it like a TI is now. Come on. Hustling is getting it done. It's the grind with no respect for time. You can learn something from a hustler because he don't use excuses. He or she doesn't use excuses in the hustling life. You can learn. What can you learn from a hustler? You can learn how to get up before the early dawn. You can learn how to put up or shut up. You can learn that one monkey doesn't stop a show. I need some help. What can you learn from the hustling life? You can learn that you can burn sometime the candle on both ends to do what you got to do, as they say in the hood. But you can't take the same skills from a hustling life and come over into the faith life and think that they apply because faith is principle based. I need some help. Hustling is whatever I got to do, I got to do. And I'm saying it ebonically speaking, so don't send me no emails and saying that's not grammatically correct. Hustling is doing what I got to do when I got to do it by any means necessary. But when you step or cross over the tracks into faith life, I promise you, motivationally speaking, you're going to be confused if you try to use all your skills from the streets. I need some help. Faith life is principle centered.
In scripture, it tells us that non-faith is the substance of what you're desiring, the substance of what you hope to achieve. And it is the evidence of what you can't see. The fact that I have faith alone is enough to claim the prize of my hope. The fact that I have faith is enough. How much faith do I have? Someone asked. I'm glad you asked that question. You don't need as much as you think you need, but the need, the part that you need, if you don't use it, your life is devastated without it. And for those that are following on Christ, they are told that without faith, it is impossible to please God because the center of the Christian life is faith. As I said, it begs to be repeated. You cannot bring or transfer all of the skills from a hustling life to the faith life. Hustling is that moment, get it done by whatever means necessary. Faith is that purpose-driven, mission-minded, goal-oriented lifestyle that goes from one glory in the Greek means, one connotation is to mean reflection, to go from one reflection to another. You might have looked in the mirror today and found out you had a gray hair peeking somewhere, or three or four gray hairs peeking. That means your glory has changed. You know, always just thinking about that word, glory. When you think about the word, give God the glory, meaning reflect him, mirror him. Someone said, well, we don't want to steal God's glory. We don't want to change the reflection of what he looks like and the deity and the character. You know, that's just a little education on that word glory, because it's widely misused. Trust me. What is your glory? Your faith determines your glory, by the way. What do you believe? Now, I don't have the time to go into it, and maybe in the series we'll cover this, but listen, here's the dynamic problem that we have. The problem that we have is that we're not analyzing what we're hearing. Now, set aside the Christian issue and the church issue and the Bible issue and the preacher issue, and think about it in a motivational sense or in a corporate sense or an entrepreneurial sense. What are you hearing? Now, if in fact you can analyze what you are hearing, you will find or turn a tape recorder on every time you have a conversation for the next 7 days, and that will tell you what you are hearing. But here's the kicker right here. After we analyze, then we have to make course correction. We have to make course correction. There's no way to walk the faith life without making course. It's not like the hustling life. The hustling life, if you step on somebody's toes on your way up, so be it. The hustling life, if I end up telling a little white lie on my way to get this bill paid, so be it. But the faith life, as you'll see later on in our series, has ingredients that must couple it for it to be mature. You can have immature faith, and you can have mature faith, or you can have young faith, and you can have developing faith. And then you can have no faith. I have no faith at all that the hopes that I have can be accomplished. I have no faith. I'm using this as a paraphrase that someone may be thinking. I have no hope at all because the thing, the body of my hearing has been precedented or has been predicated upon the circumstantial evidence that I have been receiving. I need some help. The body of my hearing is called into question. And a lot of people do what a lot of people do. They run to the spiritual aspect. But listen, I am not suggesting to you that the only way you can get faith is hearing the word of God. I am suggesting to you that the assessment that you need to do when this program is over is to assess the body of your hearing. What are you hearing and from whom does it hail? I need some help. What are you hearing and from whom does it hail? Who's it coming from? And then after you ask who's it coming from, you have to check the source from which such words are spoken. I need some help. That's good right there, Coach. That's good right there. Tweet me, Coach. Right on at SelectUSA TV on Twitter. What is the source? What is the credentials of the source from which I hear these words? Who is doing the talking? And then you have the types of listening. I don't have time to get into this, but you have the types of, you have the indirect listening, and then you have the direct listening, just to give it in this brief time that we have. You have the indirect listening, that which you're listening to subconsciously, but you may not be intently or directly listening. And then you have the direct listening, that which you intend to comprehend through applying a small set of skills to gather information. Well, we're gathering information whether we intend to or not. We're getting information both directly and indirectly. So it begs even more so as we go forth in this series that the first thing you have to do is assess the body of what you're hearing, even in as it emanates from yourself. Because the conclusionary or the summary of my own dreams, desires, outcomes, goals, and missions are yet still comprised by the body of words spoken to me in particular environments. And I am not sure, hence why I am a Christian, but I am not sure, hence why you may be listening to that speaker or that author, that the credentials of such persons having spoke a body of words to me holds enough water for me to continue to believe something that does not yield the fruits therein. What do you believe? What is the assessment that you will now, in a summary, be able to articulate back to yourself in your diary and in your conversations in prayer or meditations? What is the body of your hearing sounding like, looking like? When we come back from the commercial, we'll wrap things up. This is the brand new series, Faith. And today we're talking about faith life versus what? The hustling life. And take nothing else away from what I said. Remember this. What you are doing in the hustling life cannot apply in the faith life.
You're listening to the sounds of your lifestyle improvement station.
Hi, Tamika Chapel, College Park, Georgia, in the house. You're listening to FIBN Radio.
Hi, this is Ted Bones calling from Richmond, Virginia. And you're listening to the Lifestyle Improvement Station, SIBN Radio. Y'all turn it up now.
Hi, this is VJ Washington calling from Atlanta, Georgia. You're listening to the Lifestyle Improvement Station, SIBN Radio. So turn it up.
Hi, my name is Sonia Claiborne from East St. Louis, Illinois, by way of Caruthersville, Missouri. You're listening to the Lifestyle Improvement Station, SIBN Radio. Turn it up.
What's good? It's your boy Joe coming from Snellville, Georgia. You're listening to the Lifestyle Improvement Station, SIBN Radio. Y'all turn it up.
You're listening to the sounds of your Lifestyle Improvement Station, changing the way we live. SIBN-FM, powered by Summit USA TV. It's not enough to have material wealth. The measure of a man or woman is from the inside out and not from the outside in. Don't trick yourself. You will wreck yourself trying to impress others and trying to keep up with the Smiths and the Joneses. It's about time that you start looking at the finish line. And at DCC, we offer the hardest core motivation, daily inspiration for your spiritual foundation that you can find. Why? Because our philosophy is simple. We are the common denominator in every situation.
Thank you so much for joining us right here on the Coach's Corner. We are appreciative of you that have stopped by. Thank you so much. And we're talking about faith as we move forward. Faith. Today we're talking about faith life versus the hustling life. What you did by any means necessary cannot be applied to the faith life, except for some of the lessons you learned, of course. By all means, certain things are always transferable. All of what we have experienced in the hustling life is not transferable to the faith life, because faith life is principle centered and it is based on the body of what we have heard and what we are now hearing. And so if you are not hearing healthy, wholesome, positive content
all around now. You can't dig when you're trying to make a transition or trying to change a mindset. You can't cheat. If this is an emergency and you need to put your air mask on, your mask on for oxygen purposes, then by all means, we don't intermittently take it off because we're under pressure from someone around us to take it off. But we don't take it off to save someone else when we are risking our own lives in the process. Let me wrap it up. Faith life. I have come to know that hopefully in my next body of motivational speaking on this topic, faith series, I want to talk about faith and the seasons of our lives. Because I have come to the walking on water phase. Many of us are doing all the calculatory thought meditations. If I do this, then I'll get this. And then when I do that, I'll get this. And that may be good for a while, but there is a level of faith where calculations become aggravations. And I'm saying that because it rhymes and I have your time and I need a dime. No, just kidding. But seriously, if we calculate every grace, we'll be indebted as we are forever. I don't think that grace and the richness thereof is there for our calculations, but there for our appreciations. I need some help. I cannot calculate my way to success. Now, I can be intentional. I can be direct, but I cannot calculate my way to success. You see what I'm saying? And some of us are, that's where we get, that's where the faith life becomes a matter of tripping, if you will. Something that trips us because we begin to calculate, well, if I do this behavior and if I do this, we do the cause and effect calculation. We do the stay within the framework of the budget calculation. We do the calculation that is based on a number of intelligences. We do calculations based on a number of logical moves and steps. We do calculations based on the golden rule, or we do calculations based on emotional response. But when you really begin to think about the faith life and what it entails, what it requires, and what it is, it's got to be principle-centered, it's got to be consistent, it is not emotionally drenched, it is not circumstantially embraced. Faith is a standalone principle that we activate when we speak. And when we say we have faith, we do not couple it with an emotion. We do not couple it with a circumstance. We do not couple it with who said what, because all persons under God, at least in my view, have questionable intentions and agendas. I don't even want to go there. But the point is, who can be trusted? Overall, God says, I'll do what I said I would do. I'll say, and it becomes reality. And I want you to mimic me. I want you to mimic me in this. And in our lives, we have to examine the body of work to ensure that the faith that I say that I have is really the faith that I say that I have. Probably two or three motivational sessions into the series, we'll talk about the trying of your faith. Because we cannot say we have faith for something without the faith in and of itself activating by default its own analytical test to show you or to show me that what I said I believe, I believe. It's like a relationship, if I can sum it up in 30 seconds. If you say you love someone, all of those feelings are lovey-dovey. All of the meshing and all of the chemical and the chemistry and all of that, it feels great. But people that are immature don't realize that relationships, once they are formed, they begin to be involved in after the honeymoon phase. They are involved in a series of tests. Not to test whether or not you love one another, but also to test the authenticity of your heart's place for the purpose of ascending to another place. Nothing personal.
you go through to get to. I need some help. I got to get out of here. My time is gone. But in this new faith series, I want you to get at least two things. Number one, you can't bring from where the streets, the hood, the corporate back room, the cutthroat boardroom, the hustling life has some transferable skills, but the faith life has dedicated, standalone, principle-centered set of skills that those that take that quote-unquote mustard seed and work it can find their lives somewhat on autopilot, because purpose requires faith. But the moment of solving an ailment or an aggravation requires a hustle. You can learn something from the hustler, though. But I'm talking about faith-driven living. Faith-driven living. Join me right here for the series as we go forth. On the Coach's Corner, my name is Marcus Lett, a.k.a. The Coach. It's been real. It's been good. Whatever you do, hug yourself and believe.